existing out of spite. I'm existing out of spite.
I know infinity, she howls with the past, let's take out each other's eyes. I know duplicity, who once was a child born in villainy. I know infinity, she howls with the past, let's take out each other's eyes. I know what hides in me is only.
Hello, everybody. Sorry for taking so long, but Rindy directed me towards a website that just sells plushies. And by God, do I love these little bitches.
Yeah, indirect shilling. This is called fluffnest.com. Oh my God, look at some of these cuties!
God knows I plan on getting, like, when I fucking get my apartment, I'm gonna get, like, a fucking, like, net that I can, like, well, I'm getting a net, I'm gonna get a bookshelf. Just for the fucking plushies. There's a fucking bookshelf that my dad has in the basement that he says he's gonna use for whenever I move out. I'm just gonna take it with me. I don't want you to don't let him know this, but I'm just gonna fucking take it.
Use it for the plushies.
Exactly. Anyways,
look at him.
We will be cutting down the amount of VNs that we're going to be doing for a little while, but that's not going to stop me from playing Paranormicide. Paranormicide's really cool.
Yes. B, what do you think of ham?
B is
me has left
food,
for snacks.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Admittedly, you know, we're still waiting on Noir as well.
Oh, Sim, what do you think of Ham the Frog?
Which one is that? The one Orange has posted.
Yeah,
he's up here.
That's good frog.
He's good frog. His best friend.
Hmm. I will actually, real quick, grab some more.
Okay.
There's Noir.
Noir.
Oh yeah, there's Noir, yeah.
And now I'm here.
Oh shit, did yeast kens get cheaper? Oh fuck.
Yeast ken?
I need more yeast ken. Yeast ken's a little bread doggy. Look at him.
Oh my gosh!
People win them on crane. People win them on Crane Game Toriba, and then they just fucking sell them over eBay.
Oh, no wonder I see them on Toriba all the time. Oh, a lot of them have the little X's on their butts.
Yeah, exactly. The little buttholes.
Yep.
I need a new yeast, Ken. My current one's got some battle damage, so I gotta make sure that it's nice and comfy.
Battle damage.
Yeah, a little part of its outer shell broke. So once I can find a replacement for him, I'm going to put him up on a nice shelf so that he's safe and protected.
Why not get a Toriba so you can try to go ahead and win?
I don't want to. To give you an idea, what is it? The reason why I wanted a yeast ken is because Wayne Radio TV. Did Crane Game Toriba. It took him $150 fucking dollars to get a Yeast Ken plushie. I bought it for $35. I think I'm good. I think I'll just buy one.
What if you get it on your first try?
Then unbelievable luck guides my way.
I've actually had that kind of unbelievable luck.
Good for you. Unfortunately, despite my propensity for playing roguelikes and gacha games, I detest gambling and think it's bad. Why would I want more money when all the money I have is right here, idiot?
Hey! Crane games aren't gambling.
It is! You're just gambling for plushies. Like, obviously there is a distinct amount of skill that's required for these kind of things, but also it's largely luck, because they kinda go off on, like, making it so, like, it's really fucking largely difficult luck to actually get one.
Or skill.
Mm-hmm.
So it's exactly like a normal crane game.
Yeah. Oh, that's why. Okay. 327, yes. Oh. Oh yeah, that's right. Didn't we fucking... I think we got, like, the break, actually, down here. And then she ate shit super hard, I think.
Mm-hmm.
I believe we need more data. Well, fortunately, I think we're about to get more data. So let's just go ahead and get some more data.
It's got a good data plan.
Midoriya Cho Park. Tetsuo Tsutsumi. Meh.
Tsutsumi.
Let's go to Midori Kawa Park. Mm-hmm. Ufu.
Oh, got my neck.
My ishi days. Excuse me.
My ishi days.
Sorry to bother you, but we have some questions for you. Oh yeah, fuck, I was voicing this guy, wasn't I?
What? Are you with the police? I haven't done anything yet.
Eh, don't worry. This isn't an interrogation or anything. You just want to talk. You're Hideki Arashi, right? The historian? We know who you are, so this won't take long.
Since we saw you here, I'd just like to ask you a couple questions.
Fun fact, kids never talk to cops.
Very true.
Mm-hmm. Or historians.
Hey, you know, not unless they have a warrant or unless they actually do have any major propensity.
You know, there's not like...
Cops. We all hate cops.
So true, honestly.
Let's get over with. I'm a busy man.
Especially feds.
Now, Mr. Araishi, what were you doing here at this time of night?
I'm doing research, of course. Data information never sleeps.
That's an admirable philosophy. You know, your research has been quite the talk around town. What is it they were saying? Discovered something about some book.
Okay, so let me just go ahead and take in all of these. We have the Record of Fate, the Record of Fates, the Record of Dates, the Book of Fates, the Book of Dates, the Scroll of Fates, and the Scroll of Dates.
Oh, fuck, what was it called again?
I'm going to assume it's the Book of Fates.
I mean, can you...
Okay, now that's not it.
Fool.
I say, can you check the thing mid-sentence?
Oh my god, look, yeah, they looked at they looked at the screen. Like, what the fuck, man?
Left, left, wow.
Let me go find the clip.
Roll the clip.
Just instantly, they both look at the screen like, dude, what the fuck? You've been playing this long. That's persons of interest.
Let
me look at the group person again.
Let's see, so...
With Jabba the Hutt. Wait, I'm gonna look at Jabba the Hutt again. Where is
Jabba
it?
You mean Fumichika Nejima?
Yeah, there
he is. Yeah, Jabba the Hutt. There he is.
You mean, obviously, Brendan Fraser from The Whale?
No, his hair is nowhere near that long. Or luxurious.
Yeah, his hair is actually pretty nice.
Yeah, that's right here. Let me get the fucking edit I made really quickly, because I said I was gonna edit this guy's face, and then I did. Yeah, I did.
Oh,
I have to
scroll
back up through the meme channel, because I don't think I actually saved a copy of it. Let me fucking find it.
He looks like a character that was rejected from Metalocalypse.
He looks like someone who is consistently greasy.
He looks like... fucking a Men in Black alien wearing a human skin.
Yeah, I was gonna say, yeah, he looks like Vincent D'Onofrio in Men in Black.
A little bit, yeah.
I mean, if his eyes were a different shape, it would work fine, but with the eyes like that, it looks like he's got
that Innsmouth look.
He does. That's why he wears his hair like that, so you don't notice he has gills for ears.
I was gonna say he looks like some sort of fish man posing as a human in our human society.
Oh wait, fuck, I opened up the goddamn...
Well, they do live near a river.
The river.
Did I save a proper copy of this? Oh no.
Oh my god,
a proper copy.
Oh no.
Girl, here. Shake that proper copy.
Here, don't worry, I can just... Here, it's very simple, alright?
God damn it, Noir.
Oh! Oh god, my wrist!
In memes and humor... by... Or from? Yeah, there we go. From... Justin... Oh my goodness.
He looks like what a more humanized version of, oh god, what was his name? From the first episode of Smiling Friends, Desmond.
Oh, you mean that ant? Yeah, I guess it doesn't make me feel a lot better.
Okay,
See, this guy doesn't have blubbly control.
Huh, I guess the old Desmond dude was just a new purpose in life. I cannot fucking wait for season 2.
What the fuck?
Is that loud?
While Orange is currently looking for this meme, how has everybody else been?
Okay.
Pretty alright.
Sim? Noir?
Good.
So you guys hear that Pat's gonna be a dad, right?
Yeah.
Mr. Boivin.
Yeah, sorry, Mr. Boivin.
Mr. Boivin.
Oh, is it Boivin?
Boivin.
No, I'm just saying it in French because he's Quebecish.
No, it's just Paige and Pat are gonna have a kid.
Mr. Quebecois. I can't believe there's gonna be another Pat. The world is not ready.
Somehow be even shorter and even balder.
You know? Paige talked about, they had the ultrasound, the baby is 50% percentiles on all his sizes, except his belly, which is 90th percentile, and his legs, which are 20th percentile.
See, the good thing is they'll stay on clothes.
If there's one thing we know for sure, is that she definitely did not cheat on Pat.
Let's just hope that that little kid does not end up with Paige's health issues.
Oh,
you mean
here
the mustard drinking?
Oh, shit.
Oh, you found it?
Found it, yeah.
Alright, well, let's see this madness.
Alright.
Yeah.
But in all honesty, though, I've seen little kids with severe health problems in schools.
So the first edit that I did was remove any lines towards his chins.
Oh, so God, it just that makes it so he.
I just made it so it's just like one consecutive creature.
It's a worm.
That's just a worm, yes.
And then I realized, you know, I could go one step further really quickly. So I did this.
Thanks, now I really hate it.
He found it floating back. Like, now it's kind of cute.
This looks like a weird character in a Bob's Burgers show.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. Like it doesn't. Mm-hmm. Now it just doesn't look human enough to trigger it. It's past the uncanny valley.
It doesn't look like he doesn't have a chin. It just looks like he has a thumb-shaped head.
Yeah.
Hello, my name is Thumb.
Hello. Perhaps I fell off the path.
Jesus yeah. Christ, man! Why do you erase? The first one is cursed. The second one's worse.
Oh wow, it's really fighting me to put this up on stream. You know what? Let's just get back to it.
Yeah, you can put them up on Twitter later.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. Be sure to visit us at twitter.com/.
It's just at Just an Orange.
Yep, it's just that easy.
So it's not Book of Fates, right?
Yeah, no. Hold on a second. We didn't actually like see what he
was. I
was
gonna say,
oh, yeah.
You spent.
It's because you're looking through persons.
The amount of research you did looking for this meme rather than looking.
I needed to see the thumb man B.
Priorities.
Hey, are you saying when this goes on YouTube, this will be in the thumbnail? it doesn't say here either.
So let's. Nope. Yeah, no, it doesn't.
Okay. Look in files.
Culture and society, maybe?
It's probably there, yeah.
No.
Didn't they say it before in the dialogue, maybe?
Seven mysteries, phenomena/curses. The Record of Fates. It's
fate.
Called the Record of Fates.
And you can't go back on that one, though.
Well, of course.
Oh, it's fine.
Obviously, it's the Record of Fates. How rude.
It's the Record of Fates. How rude.
You're gonna be so owned when I go back in the visual novel flowchart and read it back in your face.
You know what, you actually, why not just do that right now, here.
Can you do that?
Yeah, like, we can just do that right now, it's fine. We're like 5 seconds into the actual chapter.
Oh, I'm sorry. Obviously, it's the Record of Fates. Only an idiot wouldn't know that. You're gonna get Flowey coming in here being like, I saw what you did.
Mm-hmm. That's a wonderful idea.
Alright, yeah. Back to the questioning.
Bothering me again?
Yeah.
Imagine if he said that. It's the second time you cop stuff.
What the fuck are you dumbasses doing?
It's the Record of Fates.
I hope it goes. What? No, it's called the Book of Fate. What are you talking about?
Found some kind of ritual in the Record of Fates.
What? Don't tell me you're gonna do it to kill you at the Rite of Resurrection too. I'm perfectly honest, I'm tired of people asking me about it all the time.
Then why the fuck did you write about
it? Turning into meat wad.
None of you even care about the local history. You just keep crawling out of the woodwork when something interesting comes up.
Yeah.
Looks like I hit a nerve.
If you can force me to tell you because you're policemen, you're sorely mistaken.
About his research. Are you doing all this research so you can use the Rite of Resurrection yourself?
You're a policeman. Do you really think people can bring the dead back to life? Everyone I meet. Pitiful.
Huh? Okay, I think
so you don't believe in the right?
Sorry to break character like this, but I think my dog thinks your voice is another dog because he would not stop barking when you were talking.
Whether it's real or not has nothing to do with my research.
Well, dog's just like the baby voice.
That is not a baby voice.
That is a. I'm voicing a creature. This is not a man anymore. He's a wad of meat.
This is Kermit, but he lost his tongue.
Those things are better left to the occult freaks.
Don't disrespect Kermit.
I actually like that better. Well, you see, this is the Dark Kermit saga.
No, so I thought. Huh? Hmm? Things changed. It became necessary for me to pursue the right. The Kermit voice is funnier than the meat wad voice.
Yeah.
So now, fuck. So now I pray that that is real.
What changed?
I'm sure you can imagine. the funds for my research.
What?
I received a large amount of funding for seeking the Rite of Resurrection. And if I find it, I'll receive a sum so great that I never have to worry about money again.
Capitalism.
Oh, and that means someone is sponsoring your research.
Yeah, you see, I'll get like $5 in 1984, which is like one shit zillion dollars in 2023. Yeah, so what if they are? You have no idea how hard we work to secure funding for our research. I have no interest in teaching those children.
God damn.
What are you gonna do about it, bitch?
Listen to me. I'll tell you one thing. Those experts you see writing provocative books or spreading nonsense on TV to try and get popular? All of them are just trying to get the money they need to do their research. With how popular the occult is, saying something even remotely spooky can lead to big money.
I hate what? It, but he's got a point.
But I bought your book!
Fucking Holden Caulfield out here.
The pursuit of the unknown begins, first and foremost, with belief. I was so inspired by that bit! I do appreciate your patronage. Unfortunately, however, the occult is not my true interest.
What a bitch.
He's being patronizing about the patronage.
fucking Maria Umaneko just like comes down from the top rope and just knees this dude in the fucking gut.
So what you're saying is that you should be voicing this character like Erica.
The fate of the unknown is to be destroyed by your research and deep consideration.
Erica, but make it Virgilius. Go.
No way. I can't believe it.
You're surprisingly innocent.
Then what kind of research do you want to be doing?
I'm sure it wouldn't interest you. But to put it simply, the focus of my research is how historical accounts transform into folklore over the years, and now they are passed down from generation to generation.
That's very normal and very cool, actually.
Man,
what?
Yeah, that's like saying I'm going to research the past and then see what that's like saying I'm going to study history.
That sounds like you're a folklore historian, bro. Yeah. Come on. Yeah.
Oh no, he's Korakio.
What does that mean?
Due to human bias, the account of any event is inevitably changed by the person communicating it. This is not necessarily done with ill intentions. It happens when someone tries to fill in the gaps in a story that lacks detail. Or when something's left out or abridged because of the story's length. And when a story twists and shifts as it spreads throughout oral tradition. Even when two stories are told about the same event, differences in cultures or environment will affect how it's told, changing its content. Silly little things can turn into terribly mysterious legends. My research in the study of how history, culture, and legends all influence each other.
Wow, social anthropology, nigga.
Yeah.
It actually does sound pretty cool, I won't lie.
Take the seven mysteries of Honjo, for example. Why are some of the mysteries seemingly about nothing particularly interesting? Your stories wouldn't last a decade, let alone hundreds of years, so why?
The fuck is your mythology so fucking boring, eh?
Perhaps putting it that way piques your interests.
I admit, I am curious.
That's what you've been researching all this time. Makes sense.
What a fucking nerd. Just do anthropology.
It was the 80s. You weren't allowed to be a nerd.
I mean, he is doing anthropology.
He is, but he's just using occult research and teaching to fund his, like, actual interests.
Which is... Actually, no, I can't fault him on that. That's actually a really good
business.
Kind of
like what we're doing right now.
Yeah, I... Wow, I really...
That's right. Be sure to subscribe and hit that bell.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. There's a bit.
So that way we can bring you even greater things.
Look forward, because of it. Maybe someday I might be joining Noir in the shilling my own personal book circuit.
Only
join
time
us next
can
week,
tell.
Whenever... Join us next week when we talk to Henry Winkler about reinstalling a kitchen sink.
Mm-hmm. Now back to it.
Yes, I said it doesn't matter to me whether the right exists or not.
Sorry, did you want to finish that bit, B?
No, I'm good.
Okay.
If people in the Edo period believe that what was written in the Record of Fates was real, that's all I'm interested in.
I mean, I guess that's actually a pretty fair thing to do, because, like, what is it? Main character boy, the original dude, Shoko Ogie, like, he got his spirit gauge full up, and then he just fucking died anyway. So, I don't know. Maybe what's written down about the record, the Rite of Resurrection is actually false.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, this is just fucking description.
Wait, he didn't try to use it. He got killed by someone.
Hmm. Perchance. That or just collecting all the souls killed him.
Neither or. Remy, no.
I mean, that would be real funny and ironic.
Yeah, but I have to be realistic, you know? The research I'd like to do is unfortunately not very lucrative. That's why I need to take some risks.
Okay, that's that.
This record of fates. Where did you get your hands on it?
Yeah, the source of an old private residence in the city. Just the public was told.
Fucking broke into the murder storehouse.
This dude really is just fuck.
Takano?
Takano, yeah. Oh my god, I'm sorry.
Studying the past.
My brain is like trying to make my Higurashi information run away from me.
I am unable to be more precise due to agreement with my informant.
Was the research you were doing just now also related to the Rite of Resurrection?
Well, yeah, that's right.
What exactly were you looking for?
I have no reason to tell you that. You would understand anyway.
What are you looking for? Shut up!
Well, in that case, I think I might have a guess as to what it is you're looking for.
Cursed bears?
Cursed stones.
I mean, I feel like these all do kind of relate to each other specifically, but I think I'm just gonna go for cursed stone specific.
What? Damn it! If you know about that, then...
Calm down. No need to get so defensive.
I'm not getting defensive.
It would be best to go ahead and take a road where you can show it to him and then say...
Show him your loaded gun and tell him you can kill him at any point.
Here's my gun.
It's accurate intimidation.
Both want information, right? Why don't we have a nice friendly chat?
A curse stone? You are a curse bearer?
And she said you didn't believe in that.
A leaf. Is it the Evergreen Beach then?
Yep. Will you show me yours?
This is mine. The Everburning Lantern.
There it is!
Interesting.
Oh, he was the guy in the building we
He's
couldn't see.
The guy in the
see.
Dark.
Yeah.
Oh,
man
shit.
Called on purpose.
Yeah, that's right. Oh, yeah. We had that revelation last time. It was just 2 weeks ago.
Sure was.
I'll keep the curse details.
Because you know how his curse works. There's no reason.
Yeah, true.
Yes, but he doesn't know how ours work.
And that behooves us, because he might just murder us.
So, we have a second curse stone, don't we?
Yeah.
That is also true.
We have a second one?
Exactly, it's the
second
one.
Yeah, we picked up the feet one before.
Oh, yeah!
And then you're like, you now have the feet curse as well.
Here, I think we'll just let's just go for the honesty pour. The honesty pour.
I'll tell you this for free. The Evergreen Beach comes from a man was hanged for spreading false rumors. The accusations against him were unfounded, and he died cursing those who deceived him.
So that is the resentful memory held within the Evergreen Beach. The memories of the Seven Mysteries are truly fascinating. Oh, if only I could collect them all.
Do whatever you want, but you should know something. This stone of mine lets me curse anyone who tries to mislead me. So don't try and lie to me. Oh no.
You would curse a citizen? And you call yourself an officer of the law.
That all depends on you. I don't want to use it if I don't have to.
What is it you want?
The curse stones are dangerous. I'd like to confiscate yours.
Excuse me? But my right.
You have no rights.
First, let me ask you one thing. You haven't used the curse, have you?
No, of course. I haven't, I swear.
I see. Good. Now, why don't you hand over that stone? Unless you'd rather try using it on me instead.
Damn you! I won't give it to you! If I were to say that, what would happen? Would it be a crime?
Police are aware of how dangerous the stones are. I could arrest you under Article 1, Section 2 of the Minor Offenses Act.
Ooh.
Or you hand it over, and all you lose is your secret ability. Think of what would happen to all your research if you were arrested.
Also, the curse literally only does one thing, and it's kill people.
Fine. You can have the stone here.
Doesn't he have another stone too, though?
I got three stones now, man.
I don't think so.
Oh, didn't
good take choice. I look forward to seeing how your research pans out.
Yo, Tsutsumi kicks ass.
Oh, right. Would you tell us everything you know about what's been going on? If you help us out, we'll give you all the information we've gotten after we solve the case. What do you say?
In that case, will you tell me about all the resentful memories of the seven mysteries? I believe they are the key to the secret hidden in the Record of Fates.
Sure, why not? I'll let you learn. I'll learn about them as I collect the curse stones.
But thanks to you, we learned a lot from him.
I wonder. The mysteries in the right are all public information. He kept everything he knows about the other curse bearers and the source of the curse here hidden. I was hoping you'd at least give us a clue about how to beat these curses.
Oh, I see. They should be more aggressive next time. Really make them spit it out. And by we, I mean you.
I'm guessing he wants to save this curse. He wouldn't have told us anything no matter what we asked. But now we know where he hangs out. We can always send someone for him if need be.
Right. Wait. Got it. I was supposed to hear that there are actually nine of the seven mysteries, though.
Yeah. There's two extra curse bearers we have to find.
There are nine.
I've confiscated two, so there are six more. Could be anywhere in this town.
We have to find them fast, or they might start using the curses.
No. I think we're already too late.
Huh?
I didn't tell you this. There are some soul dregs in Namigaki? Yeah. Namigaki's curse stone.
Really? Then you already killed someone with it?
It's not much, so it probably wasn't a curse bearer. Yet. Well, you know who did it. Can make arrangements to take him into custody.
Can you?
We'll have paranormal affairs pick him up tomorrow.
If the cops know that it is a deadly weapon, yeah.
Well, but how can
we continue our search?
Okay.
But is that admissible evidence?
Paranormal affairs.
Yeah. In the paranormal investigation squadron. Yes, well, yes, it is.
This implies that there's going to be a paranormal prosecution on this.
Yeah,
it's probably.
Is everyone in on it? Is there an entire legal system that is aware of the curse shit going on?
Probably,
yeah. Mm-hmm.
It says right there in the Japanese Constitution, if you kill someone with magic, you are exempt from normal legal discourse.
You said go to the paralegal discourse.
We have categorical proof that you murdered someone with soul magic.
This is a bio.
Directly to jail.
Right. On to the next place. We just have to cross them off the list one by one. Oh, but boss?
Hmm.
Good to know we can use the Minor Offenses Act to arrest people with curse stones. But why didn't we do it with Namigaki?
We could do that. There'd be no need for paranormal affairs. Grounds would a normal detective have to put him under arrest.
Hmm. Yawn.
All right. Yeah, I suppose that's true. Cool. Oh. We literally cannot do theirs yet.
Oh, well.
I see.
Anyways, yeah, here. Let's help her escape, actually.
Escape.
Escape.
What do you think start from the school gates.
Oh, wow. This is very specific, checkpoint system. That's very nice.
Unless it's actually stretched out like a full line.
Oh boy, from the start, like, just ruined everybody's fucking day.
Just fucking running around, kill, kill, kill! You are Yako,
right? Yeah, right. Mia's late. I've been waiting for 20 or 30 minutes, but there's no sign of her. Huh? There's someone coming down the road. It's so funny. So why is it? Wait, he doesn't know what to do with his hands.
Just walking with your hands.
Mom said it's my turn on the Xbox.
He's like 2 degrees away from it just being a power stance.
He's doing that Danganronpa general sprite stance.
Oh, he just needs to do like an A pose and he's good to go.
Oh no, teacher. It's Mr. Araishi. He looks an edge. I wonder what he's doing.
So wait, why the fuck is a high school teacher doing like historical research?
You'd be surprised what teachers can do in their free time in Japan.
In their half pipe.
I mean, he did just say that, saying he doesn't care about teaching the kids, he just wants money for, like, his actual research.
I know, but, like, wouldn't he go to university then?
It's weird he doesn't just get tenure or something, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm wondering if, like...
Why'd you get a degree in teaching?
I'm wondering if, like, maybe he... I don't know. He just says that he's kind of, like, looking for funding wherever he can get it, so I guess, like, maybe he's just... Maybe he can't, like, quite cut it in university or some shit? I don't fucking know.
He doesn't give enough of a shit to be able to teach in a university.
In the 80s in Japan, the universities wouldn't really have much of an interest in it. So, of course, the next step you'd have to go would be one lower than that.
Plus, like, from what I can understand, okay, let's just get going. Yeah.
Wait, he's the one who discovered the Rite of Resurrection. It wouldn't be strange for him to be involved with the curses. What if he has a curse stone? What do I do?
Stabbo.
But it's way past the 10 minutes Mio said she'd be here by. I managed to escape. I can't let it go to waste. I need to get out of here before anyone sees me.
Oh, okay. Back home.
Cool.
More like yak home.
Sennoya.
I'm home. Thank goodness. I don't think the walk has ever felt so long. Nobody will be able to use the curse once it's light outside. I need to go look for Mio as soon as it's morning. But for now, I need some rest.
Hell yeah. Good job.
You did it.
Sis is just going to take a nap.
He's just like me for real.
Obtained the sleepy bitch ending.
Oh, yeah, that's the completed the Yako branch of chapter one. She's just done.
Of chapter one?
Yeah,
sleepy bitch ending.
Yeah, baby.
Alright, back to the mouth.
Like the hard way.
Arara. Arara.
Arara.
Arara.
I'm back here again. I left Richter to continue looking for curse bearers. I regret to inform you.
I forgot that his name is Richter.
Yeah.
I forgot.
And came home alone. Who's in my house waiting for me?
No, that's it!
Why? Okay, then.
Yeah, that's shit. So funny. I love this.
Threatening phone call.
Alright.
Damn. And scene. Okay.
Road.
On the road again.
Can't wait to get back on the road again.
I'm in music with my friends. I can't wait to get on the road again.
Well. This will have visited every place connected to the Seven Mysteries.
This is the last spot, huh? We've got nothing to show for it. Even though every last location looks suspect from top to bottom.
Maybe we came at the wrong time. Might not have been any curse bearers around.
Sounds like we need to do another round before morning comes in.
Or maybe someone's been observing our movements.
What? No way!
It's just a thought. Either way, we should check out this last place.
Let's hope we finally get a lead. Kinchibori Park.
Oh!
Oh, I wonder... Oh, no!
Hello.
Basic bitch is dead forever.
Whoa. What the hell is this?
Is he dead?
Damn it. We were too late. Is this a curse too?
Man, I'm glad I'm not that guy.
Hang on. I'm gonna call this in.
I'll leave it to you. I'm gonna take a look around.
You had night with a curse. Maybe a guy just stabbed him.
Mm-hmm. No
way to tell.
Wait, did he get killed by Feet Boy? boss,
he probably got killed by the weirdest agent that came here during his story.
But from what I can tell, remember when we killed him before
he was
a curse bearer?
Well, he was technically a curse bearer. He just got a curse at that point.
No, Oh, sorry, go ahead.
No, it's fine. What's up?
Let's say, because the dude who snuck up on him, like, wasn't... He didn't have a curse stone. He just, like, killed him and stole...
Well, we don't know for sure what happened. We don't actually know exactly what happened.
Like
he just turned around and died.
Well, like, we kind of, like, judged it based on, like, the amount of, like, soul drag bonus you got, and he only got, like, 1%, which just means that he's, like, a regular dude. Anyways.
Maybe. I don't know.
Another mysterious death is reported in the area just now. The medical union and forensics team are on their way. It'll be a while before they arrive.
That is bad news. They got someone else.
You think this is the worker of the curse bearer? Of a curse bearer?
With suspicious deaths popping up one after another, we have to assume it is. Yet. Guess we'll be stuck waiting around for a while.
Hey. Oh, okay. Oh. Huh? Boss, the phone is ringing.
Who just calls a payphone?
Well, this is the 80s.
Can you do
creepy
that?
Creepy Pete. You is can. The problem is that you'd have to assume that whoever you want happens to be there right then.
Mm-hmm. Well, better go check it out.
You're right. But be careful. It could be a curse.
Hey, I said we. You expect me to go alone?
Yep. You're the one who's tough against this stuff. Don't worry, boss. You can do it. Go on now.
Damn it.
Aereo, you have no means of supernatural defense, dude.
He has a gun. Hello. Kinchibori Park phone booth.
No, mama, let me whisper in your ear. Good evening.
Evening, Detective Satsumi. How are things looking out there?
Who is this?
I finally got him. The real deal, Detective Tsutsuo Satsumi himself. Oh, wait, that's Chief Inspector Satsumi now, isn't it?
Wait, Noir, use Bane voice.
You've come a long way since we last met.
I asked you to identify yourself.
Man, have you already forgotten already? After all the time we spent together.
It's the kidnapper!
What a time that was. As I recall, I gave you quite the runaround.
It's the dude who kidnapped Haraway's son!
Is this...
Who was that, though? Oh no, it's Fumichi Kanetsu.
What? Did you say Fumichi Kanetsu?
Isn't he
like
dead?
Like the one from the Nejima murders?
The one who was let out recently?
Well, You got it! I had a feeling that the great chief Satsumi would remember me.
This means we gave the thumb guy the Bane voice.
Yes.
I spent 20 long years in a cell thanks to you. That shit was not easy.
You should be thanking me. Have given you plenty of time to thank and atone for your sins.
I was born into the prison system, molded by it.
Okay, let Nora do it.
That it did. I've repented. My conscience is as clean as a whistle.
Bullshit. 20 years in prison doesn't even begin to make up for the shit you did.
It didn't turn him into a pussy.
I don't know about that. After all, the justice system was gracious enough to grant me parole.
What? This is the real Fumichiki Nejima. He must still have a grudge against me for arresting him. So this is the pay. So is this payback? Damn it.
Couldn't you just have him arrested for this? Like, you're just threatening a police officer.
What is your goal?
Now, you gotta understand. I've repented, seen the light. I've been a good boy since I was granted parole. I even got myself a job. I've been real serious about walking the right path.
Well, that's very nice. Keep it up.
But it was no good. When the opportunity arose, it was impossible to hold myself back. I knew I had to give a little token of thanks, or I'd never be truly able to have a fresh start. Do you get what I'm saying?
No, thanks. I don't need anything. Don't need to do all that for me. Just try to live a quiet life.
Oh, it's no hassle. No hassle at all. It would be all too easy to just kill you, to tear you apart.
Do you have a curse stone?
But that wouldn't be very satisfying. Certainly not after 20 fucking years of waiting.
Long time to nurture a grudge.
You fucking bet it is. I let it knock me, grow inside of me. I thought of nothing else.
I'm so glad.
All that time I played model prisoner, endured the harassment those asshole guards threw at me. And I did it all for you, Tsutsumi. So please, just accept my deepest and most sincere feelings.
Sorry, but I'm afraid I don't feel the same way about you.
R.I.P. Susumi Nejima ship.
Shut the fuck up! That attitude of yours is why I'm saving you for last.
Are you planning? Whatever it is, bring it on. I'm not running away.
I just told you I'm not coming for you next yet. Pay attention when people talk, shithead. You see, this time I want to see you on your knees, weeping in despair, begging me for mercy.
Old man Yowie.
Let's go.
Is it slowly zooming in on his face?
No. I'm so sorry, dear Nejima. Please forgive me. I won't do it again.
Shut the fuck up! This is exactly why I've always hated you so fucking much.
Shut the fuck up!
It was worth a shot.
Did you really think that would save me, asshole? You must be crazy.
Clearly, Nejima has never heard of
Sarge. Well, then, we're both crazy. We've got so much in common. We should be friends.
Enjoy cracking your jokes while you still little can. I'm going to kill everyone you care about, one by one, till there's no one left.
I really disappoint, but I'm a lone wolf. I don't have anyone like that in my life.
I'm suddenly standing Arios right happens. Fucking here!
Why would you assume daughter? I give a shit about you?
Joke's on you, I'm divorced.
I'm divorced. And my, literally. I'm divorced and my daughter hates me. Good luck, asshole.
Boss, what about me? Or wait, are you just trying to protect me?
There's not a single person you care about? I wonder what your sweet daughter would think if she were to hear that.
Just going like, oh man, this is really gonna fuck up my plan to bring back that ancient artist.
Oh, that gets it.
Don't you fucking dare, I'm warning you.
Ooh, very nice. This is more like it.
Oh, the zoom-in sped up.
She's living all on her own now, isn't she? Attending university and all. Such a good girl. Oh my, don't tell me that she just so happens to live in Hanjo.
She does? No, forget it. This isn't funny, asshole. I'm gonna find you and make you pay.
Ah, I love it. Keep going, I want to hear you lose your mind. It's music to my ears.
Fuck you.
I look forward to chopping up your precious daughter. It'll be just like old times.
I won't let that happen.
How did he find it?
Okay.
I'm still looking forward to it.
How do you know where I am?
That's my favorite part. The sound of confusion in your voice. It's to die for. This is delicious. I can't get enough.
Answer the question, fat man.
I'm not telling you shit. Have fun racking your tiny little brain for it. What?
Tell him about your specific set of skills and shit.
I guess I could give you a little hint.
Go on.
Well, you see, I have the one-sided reed.
My God.
Tsutsumi, you have the Evergreen Beach, no?
Nejima. You're a curse bearer. You're using the power of the curse. Because you're a curse bearer.
Indeed. And what a peculiar curse it is that I bear as a curse bearer. But that's where my hints end.
God damn it, the curse echo couldn't have fallen to worse hands.
Ah, one more thing we should discuss. In fact, it is the most important of things.
I thought you were finally gonna shut up. I'm already sick of you, so I'll pass.
Sorry, cut out there for me.
Oh, but you don't want to miss this. It's the main course. I could just go after your daughter, but something tells me you'd get bored.
No, I'm good. You got me real fired up. You're in my head. Well done.
But this is a gift tailor-made for you. I'm going to kill all the people you swore to protect. Every last person living here.
What?
You couldn't. The city?
Oh, but with this curse of mine, I can.
I guess it just means, like, everybody, like, within, like, the general curse radius.
I'll give you until dusk.
Wrong game. It's called Until Dawn, Hotel idiot. Dusk.
By then, I could probably get a couple hundred people or so.
Yes, you meant
hotel desk, actually.
And it'll be all your fault.
He might just be a fan of boomer shooters. It could just be Dusk.
Oh, it must be so hard. You know, they'll all die because of you. So tragic. It must be tearing you apart.
Wait, he did say until dusk, didn't he? But right, the next thing that's gonna come up be done, and the curse doesn't work during the day.
Don't worry about it. Wait, did they say that?
It's a decent assumption to make, but I mean, good luck.
Like, I don't think this, like, it's
just
fine. Based off the prologue, I assume this would be like 7 hours or whatever until the dawn.
No. I mean, it's like 4 a.m. right now.
Yeah, like, it'll be like 2 hours from now.
Fuck with me. There's no way an amateur like you could pull off a curse that strong. Plus, I have God and anime on my side.
Unfortunately for you, I absolutely can. My curse stone is a particularly strong one.
Yeah, but they don't work during the day.
Which means I can have my fun without needing to hold back one bit. It's almost like the Feast of Shadows was cast just for me.
You're surprisingly well informed about this. Who was it that tipped you off?
Who knows?
And how about I kill myself first and ruin all your fun? What about that asshole?
Bro, what the fuck are you
talking about? What if I fucking kill myself, huh? Dead one!
Idiot! You think I'd call it off just because you were dead? There's no running away for you.
I'll find you. I won't let you get away with this, Najima.
You've got 12 hours. Do you really think your paltry little organization will be able to make a dent in my plans?
So I guess it does work in the day? Or, oh no, he's going to hold... The curse thing will go on until the next night. Like, it goes until somebody, I think, completes, the rite.
I guess.
But they don't work during the day.
Mm-hmm. Oh, the sacrifices made will be heavy. I can't wait to see you sobbing with regret. And I'll even have enough soul dregs to pull off the rite of resurrection. How splendid.
Wait, Najima, you're after the...
Anyways, see you around. Bye-bye now.
Batman.
Batman.
Wait.
What?
Who would Najima need? I just had a thought.
Boss!
Ario, did you catch all that?
Najima, what is he planning?
Who knows? For now, we need to find him and get him into custody. Send word to HQ. The fact that the seven mysteries are wrapped up in this is gonna make things tricky.
You mean with Najima being a curse bearer?
Just our luck, really. Couldn't have been a worse guy. Sounds like his curse will be able to kill a lot of people at once. Like to avoid getting our investigators caught in the crossfire. Use him to find out where he is. But then, we're going in alone. We should try to collect as many curse stones as we can before then. Let's hurry.
Aye aye, boss!
Orange, there's a little bit of static coming from your mic when you talk.
Okay. Later. Oh, here, let me change up the audio shit really quick, like. Damn, it sounds like, what is it, fucking... This is, like, a really solid, like, track to play, like, the end of, like, an episode, shit. Reported that a total of 3 suspicious deaths were discovered that night. Najima's threats, along with the curses, were kept secret from the general public. However, the Honjo serial killing still made international headlines following the death of police officer Hajime Yoshimi. At Tsutsumi's request, a large-scale investigation was launched into Fubichika Nejima's whereabouts. Tsutsumi and Ario themselves spent the rest of the night looking for curse bearers in the area.
but their search ended in vain. And with that, the curtain closed on that cursed night.
12 hours to sunset.
Huh. Well, I guess so.
Oh, shit.
Oh! Go straight to it, then.
Alright.
Yako.
Let's go back to Yako, yeah.
When we last left off, Yako got the well-deserved nap.
Yay!
She's alive, yes. Good, yeah.
Oh, good morning, Yako. Huh? Yako? Rise and shine.
Huh?
You're up.
Smart learning? I...
Are you okay? Can you remember your name?
I'm...
Yoko Sakazaki.
Yes, I'm Yoko Sakazaki.
Good. Seems like you're fully awake.
Oh, Mio. Thanks for last night. Was everything okay?
Yep. Still alive. I couldn't dispel the curse echo or learn the identity of who used it, but I managed to at least get away. But in that situation, it's the best you can hope for.
I'm sorry about you volume sounding so dangerous. I meant to look for you as soon as the sun rose, but I was just so sleepy. I can't even remember when I fell asleep.
It's okay. It's only natural to be exhausted after what you went. Besides, I also feel bad that you've been wrapped up in all of this. It's supposed to be my job to prevent that from happening.
Oh yeah, you said something about that last night. Just, who are you exactly, Mio?
I work with the police. You're a fucking pig!
Oh, well, the truth is, I've been trained in things having to do with the supernatural.
Nice. Huh? You mean you can learn that kind of stuff? Like you would with flower arrangement?
I had quite the eventful childhood.
That sounds like it must have been tough.
Yes. It would take a long time to explain, so let's leave it at that for now.
Okay.
As fate would have it, I've ended up as the apprentice, or maybe more like assistant, to a noble paranormal expert.
Notable.
Sorry about that, I can't read. Schools have always had more paranormal disturbances because young people tend to be more susceptible to these things. I'm sent to schools that may experience something paranormal and put a stop to it before it happens.
Wow, that's amazing. So it's like a part-time job you do while also being a student?
I thought that's illegal.
Well, I do help maintain public order, but it's all part of my training, so I don't get any.
Ah, there you go.
That is
it's not legal because it's not illegal because she's not getting paid. It's only legal if it's slavery.
Child labor laws? What are those? I already
did. Was this Arkansas?
You did?
Did it not pick up or.
No, he did not. I didn't get picked up, I don't think.
Okay, I'll try that again. Well, I do help maintain public order, but it's all a part of my training, so I don't get any money.
Oh. You've got it rough, then. But still, that really is amazing.
Is it?
It was so cool when you faced off against the evil spirit.
Kitty. I never know if I should be happy when you compliment me like that. But anyways... That's why it's up to me to resolve any paranormal issues at the school. And why I'm going to look into the cause of all this. But for now, let's head to school.
Yeah.
Oh, do you have your curse stone? Now that it's daytime and its power's diminished, I should be able to hold on to it. Want to give it a try?
Right. I do have it, but...
Yako.
Is it really so wrong? Trying to bring Michio back, I mean.
I can't approve of it.
Oh yeah, Ava Beatrice would probably be... Actually, no, would she be in high school? No, this would... No, yeah. this is 2 days before... Like, this is 2 years before Umineko happens.
Oh. Yeah, this is
80s. Ava Beatrice wears, like, this exact school uniform.
Yeah, no, like...
Why didn't they send Mio to solve the Ushira Mia murder case?
Well, I mean,
a school...
Yeah, wait, Umineko is 1986, isn't it?
Yeah, but a school uniform is a school uniform. Mm-hmm. So they probably just didn't change it over the years.
Like, that's just a winter uniform, yeah.
Yeah.
This is an old school one. Yeah. They don't play this nowadays.
Believe it or not, the old school lasted a long time.
I guess.
So long that it became old.
Also, they're talking about like how it's like normal for her to be that tired, but was it normal for her to be so tired she fell asleep standing up outside of her house?
Why would you do that? I
don't understand.
Curse.
It could be, yeah.
She was hit with a bio curse.
Are you a vampire?
She didn't even go back inside. She's just been standing out here for the past, like, 4 hours.
I don't know. Like, it feels... Well, that's sort of like it seemed like, but they sort of brushed over it. Like, it's not...
There are instances where people do sleep standing up.
I mean, yeah, turning her into a curse bearer, made her a vampire too, so she couldn't go inside without being invited.
What is with you and vampirism?
Listen.
It's because Randy loves aggressive vampire roleplay, what can I say?
Oh, slay on, you crazy vampire lady. I don't mean anything mean by that, by the way.
If you like no, you you're right.
More power to you.
I'm so offended that you think I fuck vampires.
Yeah, shout out to all the vampires out there, you know? We know you exist!
Yeah! We do! And call me!
Please!
And if you want to hear more about bisexual vampires, be sure to subscribe and hit that bell.
I thought you were about to say to read the Saga Song of Beagle's Oars for more about bisexual vampires, and I was like, maybe I should give it a read.
Read the Saga Song of Beagle's Oars.
Maybe I should give it a read.
You wouldn't believe the things that happen.
Also, I just love the term.
You wouldn't believe who Steve Buscemi's making out with. Will you find out? There's only one way to know.
And that's going to be an image I don't want in my brain for the rest of today.
You see?
Anyway. I wonder what the right may seem like.
All right. The right may seem like a dream come true, but if it involves taking the lives of other people, then...
Yeah, true.
I want to make sure this whole ritual ends without anyone getting hurt. That's what I believe, and what I'll put before anything else.
I'm sorry, but is it okay if I hold on to it?
Yako.
I promise, I won't use a curse, no matter what. But maybe there's some other way. I just have this feeling that I shouldn't give up on the possibility just yet. That said, I'll help you, even if...
Whoopsies, hold up.
Even if it's to stop the curse. For the Michio to still exist within me. I'll settle things so that we can move forward.
Closure.
Okay, but if you ever feel in danger, you can give me the cursed stone at any point.
Right. Thank you, Mia.
Okay then, let's go. I also had a bit of a...
She looks so pleasant. Oh no, come back! That sprite's cute!
I also had a bit of a scary thought.
Oh?
Araishi said he recently read and heard about that stuff from a different informant, right?
Mm-hmm.
And how certain legends and things can be misinterpreted or reinterpreted through other people telling stories, right?
Oh fuck, the shadow people are at school today.
Woo! Oh, no, I love Ruby. Season 1.
Man, I love Chaos Head.
Exactly.
Yo, I love Tokyo Mirage Sessions, hashtag FU.
I love Higurashi no Naka for any.
What if the right doesn't bring any particular dead back to life, but brings one specific thing?
What about the left of resurrection?
It's just bugging me.
What if the right of resurrection brings back Joseph Stalin specifically?
Why Stalin?
So it seems like it's more like the wrong of resurrection.
You fools! You've resurrected communism!
Just like shoot him again.
USSR! I thought you were dead!
It's okay. We also brought back Trotsky, so we're gonna have to just figure out that. We have to wait and see how things work out first.
We should make you believe we were gone.
Oh no, they brought back Rasputin.
Put it in age.
Oh fuck!
But
you see, that's the thing, that's what he'd do.
Oh, he's just running around having sex, it's okay. He's not doing
well,
anything.
Well, yeah, but. Yet.
Okay.
I mean, has sex with people, and he's, like, kind of religious, maybe? Like, that's like Jared Leto. Like, who wouldn't?
But.
Jared Leto is the reincarnation of.
I mean.
But. Seriously, what if someone purposely misfed Araishi information about, and the curse and all the soul dregs only resurrect one specific person for this?
Man, I love Corpse Party. Anyway,
let's keep this moving. Yeah, I'm sorry.
Uh-huh. Huh?
I thought it was initially noisy. There's a big group of people and police in front of the school.
But he's fucking dead.
Did something happen?
You mean you, because you ran away from that conflict that happened, people died? Yeah, fair.
Oh, big. She looks so big in this shot.
I already read the line.
Okay.
I'll go ask.
Thanks.
Fucking, I love this, like, mysterious high school girl adventures.
Yes, yeah, school haunted.
This isn't good.
Huh? What happened?
Don't panic, okay? First teacher who came to work this morning found something.
Okay.
Mr. Jonouchi was found dead in the middle of the school grounds.
What?
What?!
I said to not panic. You're doing the opposite. They're closing the school for today.
Oh man, my volume was at 50%. I did good.
But that's not all. I didn't know this either since I didn't watch the morning news, but...
You know, I had to do it to him.
18 people. Couldn't believe it. They hit the Pentagon.
28 stab wounds!
But... Rumors are spreading that a number of bodies were found nearby.
What? There's no way!
75 people.
Why? Could it be? Because of the curse?
We don't know enough to say. From what I heard, Mr. Jonouchi's body was in the middle of the grounds. But his body was covered in bruises, like he'd fallen from somewhere high.
Weird.
Taking into account his unnatural death and the timing, it's very unlikely this has something to do with the curse. I mean, it's very likely it has something to do with the curse. I can't read either.
You're saying someone used their curse on him last night?
Seems like it, doesn't it?
It's so scary. Yeesh. So the curses really do kill people. And someone used it.
Shh. Keep your voice down, okay? What would happen if another curse bearer heard you?
Sorry.
What an expression.
Bitch is dead. That's all you gotta know.
She sure is.
I wish we had a little more information. They've locked up the front gate. Maybe we could sneak in through the back entrance. Hmm?
Eh?
That person over
there...
That's
just Nancy Drew.
Oh,
isn't that Hitomi Okuda?
Hey, wait a minute. She was with him last night.
You're right. That's unusual.
Da-da.
Oh, but she was at the school last night, too.
Was she?
Yeah, she was. She was hanging out with that teacher, actually, yeah.
She must know something about Mr. Jonoichi. Let's see what she has to say.
Damn, did she go sprinting?
Mio, wait for me.
I love Mio. I love her sprite. I love everything about her.
Mio's great. Cute.
Mio's powerful.
I love Mio. Okay,
who she deserves her respect.
Oh,
who
man.
Because if not,
she's
I
a fucking, oh, she's okay. A fucking 1970s mean girl. Mm-hmm. She's got the old mean girl haircut.
Right?
Oh,
damn.
Yeah.
I mean, both her and Yaku have Tsukiban
haircut. Her haircut's
yeah.
All cute. Huh? So you're telling me the two of you were the ones at school last night? No sense hiding it then. Plus, I owe you one, Mio. I'll tell you everything I know.
I love her
eyes.
Eyes
are really pretty. Yeah.
Thank you.
Man, I love Charmed.
She owes you?
Oh, yeah. Right after I transferred here, there was a bit of trouble.
She gave me one of those, what was it? Oh, exorcisms.
Hmm. Huh. Oh, that's what it was.
Yeah, there was like green slime everywhere. It was kind of gross.
Just like a casual exorcism, you know? Just like a quick one, too.
Little salt here, little salt there.
Mm-hmm. Little holy water behind the neck.
Do you know she's deaf?
Did you hear about Mr. Jonouchi?
Girl, I found the body. It was sick.
Damn, this sounds like someone thought something happened in fucking an Italian crime family drama. Sit down, Uncle Tony, come on! We gotta deal with the body.
You come to me on the day of the school where there's a body on the floor, but you don't come with respect.
Damn it, now I just want to watch my Godfather movie series.
When the moon hits your eye,
like a high,
that's amore. Okay. I heard about it. I've known about it since last night. I saw that Wow!
Wow!
Sorry, that was a plot twist. I saw that asshole bite it on the school grounds myself.
Damn, he's dead? Alright, thank God.
He said, damn, boy, that's rough. Wouldn't let it happen to me, though. Bye.
she went LMAO and then walked away.
Built different.
Wrong.
What?
Oh,
you saw it happen?
Did Arashi do it?
Tell us about it. What happened exactly?
Oh, that's right. The only other person that would have been in there was the,
teacher.
Yeah. Well, there was the teacher and the janitor.
Arashi?
Which the janitor kind of... Well, like, remember, Arashi lost his ability, and he went to the school later on, so unless he, like, killed somebody outright, then yeah. The janitor, we have the theory that it could be the fucking escape... He could be the convict.
That he's Nejima, right?
Yeah, he might be Nejima.
Now. Okay.
I already read the line.
Okay.
Don't really know myself. It was pitch black. Oh, no, this is easier. It was pitch black. Mm-hmm. What I can tell you. It was almost dawn. Probably around 3. What are you doing up?
I was going to say, where the fuck
was
he
called?
Yeah, like, what was she?
It's called compensated dating. Look it up.
He started freaking out all of a sudden, ran on the grounds like something was chasing him, and screamed.
Somebody help me! Forgive me, Michio!
Oh, the plot thickens!
There's something like that while he was running around.
Michio? You mentioned Michio?
Was there anyone else out on the grounds?
It was too dark to see from where I was. But just for a second, I think I saw a girl in a school uniform with her hair in braids.
Hmm?
Oh?
Jazza Jack.
I didn't go out to make sure, so it could have been nothing for all I know. Good girl, she's just like me for real. And then I heard him begging for his life, like I was wrong, I didn't do anything. And all of a sudden his arms and legs snapped, even though he was just standing there.
Oh god!
No, I mean, he's just like laying down in a very normal human position.
No, those arms look a little off.
Mm-hmm. Only a little, though.
There's a guy like.
Only slightly.
Because, it does feel like it might be like obfuscating it a little bit to hide from the fact that it might be a curse. We don't know for sure because we can't see the body.
That is true.
I mean, you're gonna fall weird if somebody stabbed you to death.
Yeah, true.
Mm-hmm. Also, that probably would be.
There's no blood and there's no wound visible from where we can see either.
I wouldn't call that.
I think what it is because, like, you can see the thumbs.
It's
like,
expensive.
Wait. We're ignoring the part where his arms and leg broke without anything actually happening.
No,
him.
See.
I was about to say,
from this image, he doesn't look like it.
Well,
anyway,
no, because, okay.
He doesn't look broken.
If really you stab somebody hard enough, their arms and legs just shatter.
But like, look at the way, like, the thumbs are outward, and that's not normal, so, like, that looks like a fall.
It's not
like,
normal.
Because, like, if you lay down, your fingers, your thumbs face inward, so that's why I would think it was broke, because that's weird. Anyways.
Anyway, his arms and legs broke without anything being done to him?
He fell over, quit moving, so I thought I better get out of the good girl. I like her. She's just like me for real.
Do you also have a bomb ass hairstyle?
Oh yeah, all the time.
Absolutely.
Then he croaked. That's all I saw.
I confirm.
But from what you've told us, it almost sounds like Michio's ghost chased down Misa Junoichi and killed him.
What if she's lying? What if she did it?
Yeah. Let's consider
what
that.
If she has a curse though?
That is also true. Or could be true, sorry. Crazy.
And hell if I know anything about that, and I'm just telling you what I heard him say.
Mm.
Oh shit, Mio's onto me, huh?
More of Junoichi's death.
Did you tell that story to the police?
Nope, and I ain't gonna. Can't count on them for shit. Bro, she just
bottoms. Stops.
Did I tell her I saw a guy get cursed to death? No.
Well, apparently the police just are aware that that's a thing. But they listen, probably.
I think only some of the police.
I mean, to be fair, that's not much of a lead. I didn't see anything, and a guy died somehow.
Not like they believe such an insane story anyways.
True.
So all the curses work, though. You never see anything actually happen.
But there must be at least one person in the police worth trusting, right?
No, negative. The fuck?
Well...
bad apples.
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah, it's Satsumi.
There's this one cop who's always on my case about stuff. But he died just the other day.
Which is still unfortunate. Oh, he did? I'm sorry to hear that.
Bro, what is on the veranda? The fucking moonlight. Everyone who gets involved with me ends up dead.
This is moonlight syndrome.
This is the face to him.
Maybe I really am cursed. It pisses me off.
You've got it all wrong. The spirit that possessed you wasn't that kind of spirit.
Huh. And wasn't?
Yeah. This was just an unfortunate coincidence. So I'm sure that was hard enough for you.
That's all I know about that asshole's death.
Hey, Mio. I've been thinking something. If we take fresh ingredients...
Add it to the cup noodles.
Hot and ready.
The ultimate.
The way you described
experience.
It reminded me of something. The way Mr. Junoichi died, it sounds a lot like how Michio died.
Ah, damn.
That's not true at all. That's completely different. She's got blood all over and it doesn't seem to be any snapped limbs whatsoever. Of course, no, wait, I didn't hold myself.
What's going on with that other normal. Hand? No,
that is normal. I go to sleep like that. Come on. That's how
I sleep. You go to sleep covered in blood? And wow. your leg bent like that?
Yeah, look at her.
Oh, wait, I did not know. Okay, I didn't see the leg. But sometimes. I mean, only sometimes.
It's a good night.
Oh, no.
If the night.
What, you don't? Yeah. What life you live in?
When your legs convert into gelatin, you know you're getting a good night's sleep.
Oh, yeah. Of course, I didn't see it myself, but the state Michio's body was in, it was like she had fallen from high up. No, that's not me.
Mio? No, Khan's gone. Mio!
Sorry about that.
Could they have been killed by the same curse?
Could they have been killed by the same curse?
Every voice is either Bane or Kermit alternating.
I was trying to
But Noir was doing Columbo.
Well, maybe I'm stupid.
You know, Sim, you're actually correct. That was Columbo I was going for.
Oh, hell shit. Yeah.
Got it.
Yeah, this is what Columbo sounds like.
True.
Could they have been killed by the same curse?
Sounds like Shaggy got punched in the stomach.
I don't think so. The curse of the Seven Mysteries hadn't manifested when she died. And if we can trust what the spirit board said, then Michio died in an accident.
Like his only scoop, that really fucking hurt.
Oh, right.
Mio's exorcism, then.
You tell me, were we possessed by some kind of evil spirit?
Yeah, I was possessed by a spirit of a bad bitch. I don't understand it all too well myself. What I can say for sure is, thanks to Mio, the weird symptoms that were happening to me all went away.
Symptoms? Yep. Some people are born with a natural sensitivity to the paranormal. They tend to end up isolated as they struggle to relate to the people around them. They also tend to draw spirits to them naturally. This can cause strange symptoms they don't understand, like headaches, muscle stiffness, and hallucinations, even memory problems.
Yo!
I'm sure it would have been very hard.
Not Alzheimer's I have, it's just ghost possession. Thanks.
You don't have Alzheimer's.
That's how it works, huh?
To my knowledge.
People also have their personality taken over when possessed too?
It is possible with spirits who have a very close relationship to their target, like siblings or a parent and a child. But you also never hear about people being taken over completely. When the two parties aren't in sync, those negative effects start to appear.
So the seances or whatever you see on TV are all bogus?
Not quite. There are mediums and diviners who can align their minds with the spirits they call. Though there are people on TV who are just putting on a performance.
Huh.
There are people who in life had extremely powerful sense of spirit, or a deep connection to the person. But even they shouldn't be able to completely take over the person they possess. And even if they could, it'd only be enough to pressure them to choose certain behaviors that wouldn't be unusual for them to do on their own to begin with.
But if that's the case, won't you not know if you're choosing the behavior of your own will or not?
Hence why there are lots of cases where people don't even realize they're possessed. Though the spirit may influence the behavior and memories of the host. The deeper their connection in life, the easier it is for that to occur.
See, getting possessed by spirit is pretty complicated, huh? It must have been tough for you being possessed for so long, Itami.
Whatever might happen to me, it doesn't make any difference. Me being able to see spirits and stuff has nothing to do with how things ended up like this.
Yeah, it's not like being able to see them is your fault either.
The same goes for me. Maybe it's just something we have to live with. I think you have a knack for it too, you yourself, Yoko. I bet you could see them too with a little training.
Why would I want to?
I think I may pass.
It seems that she shares your sentiment.
Just like for reading real life.
So that's why you do the job you do, huh, Mio?
I thought she was a weirdo when she showed up all of a sudden saying she was gonna exercise me. If you hadn't said anything, I probably would have knocked your lights out.
I had a problem with the exorcism on her without telling her anything?
You see, in my experience, most people don't understand, no matter how much I explain. They only accept my explanation after they see the results.
I guess it makes sense.
You told me. Last night, before you witnessed Mr. Jonouchi collapse, can I ask what he and you were doing in the class?
Oh no.
Kissing.
You gonna tell the cops?
Shouldn't you?
Maybe.
Oh boy.
Oh, right. With everything that happened with Mr. Jonouchi. I suspect if we told him we saw you with him that night.
Oh, it would incriminate her. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Anytime something happens with someone like me, all those shitty adults are jumping to conclusions.
Truth. I understand. You wouldn't have been able to kill him anyway.
If you say so, then I don't mind telling you about it. So, last night... that piece of shit Jonouchi called me over here acting like he was gonna attack me something.
What? How terrible.
Whatever, I'm glad he's dead. He had it coming. Calling people worthless and a cancer in society when he doesn't know shit about them.
Oh my god.
Wow!
Whoa!
I hope she killed him now!
Right? Is what he deserves, actually.
Had it coming!
He had it coming all along!
You know, honestly, like, I'd pay good money for a deserved, game that's like, what's it called? Like, Deadly Premonition, but it's just like high school girls solving mysteries and stuff. I think it'd be
hell
fun.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that just Twilight Syndrome?
Kind of.
Alright, fair enough.
Yeah, but more dynamic.
Yes, but in English, please. Please, someone translate the Twilight Syndrome games.
And fucking our choices!
That asshole was the one always acting like scum, if you ask me.
Is that so?
At least he was being an asshole and not being, like, worse in other ways.
Could you tell us in more detail why he called you out in the middle of the night?
It's hard to explain. Where to start?
The misdeeds.
What did you mean by Mr. Jonouchi acting like scum? Was he doing something bad? Aside from being a creeper?
Aw, man.
You know Michio Shiraishi, right? The girl who killed herself?
Huh? Michio?
I don't know everything, but that creep of a teacher had some dirt on her. And he was using it to blackmail her. Call her up after school and make her do whatever he wanted. Oh, no. Ugh.
Oh god, no.
What? What do you mean when you say whatever he wanted?
I'll leave it to your imagination. Nothing that a couple of model students like you would ever get involved in.
Oh my god.
Never mind, fucking hell.
No, no, no way. That's... how? What do you mean by dirt? I don't know anything about this. How could I not have known about this?
Yako, I know how you feel, but try to calm down.
You got guts acting like you were a friend. Shonoichi really did a number on both Michio's body and soul.
Okay, I'm glad he's dead because he would need to be killed at this point. Am I right?
Yeah.
Sound off?
She probably felt like she couldn't tell anyone, like she had to suffer alone.
No. How terrible.
He told me. How do you know about this?
I just happened to walk in on it.
Oh my god!
I know the spots around school people go to when they want to stay out of sight. He ran off in a panic when I yelled at him, asking what he was doing.
Walked in on it?
I couldn't leave her alone, looking like she was about to cry, so I stuck around for a bit. She told me everything that happened in whispers. She probably figured I wasn't the type to spread that stuff around. But she never asked for my help. She told me that she was fine and to keep it a secret.
Michio, why?
She probably thought she just had to grit her teeth until it was through. And she was naive. I tried to tell her that if you give guys like that an inch, they'll take a mile. If you let a bitch shenan once, they're gonna shenan again.
It's true.
That's classic.
She kept saying about how she kept saying about how it was her punishment, and she was soft.
No.
Of course, Jonoichi didn't change. He kept doing what he was doing. I don't understand either of them, but that's as much as I was involved. And then she killed herself. Nothing I can do about it now.
He told me. If you know about it, why didn't you-
Girl, I just told you. Listen. You're trying to say it's my fault?
Easy does it.
She told me not to say anything. She told me she was fine.
She has a fang.
Does she have a fang? Oh, I missed it.
Pay attention to her mouth the next time she talks.
So what the hell more responsibility do I have other than what I already did?
Yuck. There's no point blaming Hitomi.
Michio. Why?
The dirt on Michio.
Did you hear what his dirt was?
Nope, never heard what it was. But from the sounds of it, he'd been blackmailing her since about a year ago.
With that long?
The dick probably caught her doing something she shouldn't have been. She looked well behaved, but there's more to a person than meets the eye, you know?
There must have been some reason.
Don't know. Got nothing to do with me.
Fair.
It was Ace Dick all along.
Oh. Last night, how did it start? Ah, right. Remember that nosy cop I mentioned who was always on my case? He died at the former Yasuda Gardens a couple of days ago. Yoshimi was his name. He was part of the juvenile division. Do we know this nigga?
Yeah, he was the guy who died originally in the detective's side story.
Didn't look like a cop at all. Real rough guy, but good at looking out for folks, so he was the one I could talk to. Or the only one I could talk to.
Sorry, I was getting some bubble gum that's shaped like eggs.
Jeez.
That's good bubble.
Yeah. I think it's is it double bubble? I don't know.
Hubba Bubba.
Mm-hmm. Could just be that Robin.
Big League Chew.
Huh. I didn't get to say that.
Okay, sorry.
So there was someone like that, police.
Too bad he ended up dying. Oh, another thing. One time he suddenly introduced his fiance to me. It was hilarious seeing a big guy like that act all like a shy little kid all of a sudden. She told me that she was like me when she was my age, and that she was on my side.
It must have been a terrible loss for her, too.
Yeah, I do feel a little bad for her when I think about how sad she must be.
I do hope the wife gets involved, actually.
Fiance.
And I saw him at the gardens the night he died. God damn, bro. I witnessed news ass girl.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Whenever I get worked up over something, Yoshimi always took me straight to that park. Oh, yeah, that big dude. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
He listened to whatever I was pissed off about. That day he called me over there like usual. But something seemed off about him, like he was worried about something.
Worried about something?
Yeah. He asked me for a favor too. That was pretty unusual.
Favor? What kind of favor?
He handed me a weird talisman and asked me to hold on to it for him.
Hmm? Talisman?
Yeah, just a normal good luck charm. I figured if that's it, then sure, I'll take it. I have it with me now. Curse stone. But that wasn't all. Then he told me he wanted to look for a talisman Michio Shiraishi had that looked like this one.
Hmm. Huh? Michio? What did she have to do with?
Ishimi had been meeting up and talking with her. While they were together, he noticed that she had a special talisman or something. But apparently Michio always avoided the subject.
Talisman that Michio had.
Curse stone, curse stone.
I don't think curse stones would actually be that small, though. Especially for a small in talisman.
They can, like, fit in your hand, though.
Yeah. He knew that I knew her, so that's why he asked me, he said.
They can definitely fit in your pocket.
Could there have been something Michio couldn't tell even the police about?
You know, things at home really little complicated.
From what I heard, Michio was keeping her mouth shut about what Jonoichi was doing to her. I had to talk with the cops when someone's got dirt on you. And I didn't squeal on anything about Michio either. What a ride or die, actually.
Michio, what is it that has such a strong grip on you?
So basically, Yoshimi didn't just have his eye on Michio, but her talisman too. But after she died, he didn't know where it ended up. Since I knew her from school, he wanted me to look into it for him.
Is there something special about the two talismans? I wonder why he gave it to you.
How if I know? When I looked inside it, there's just this weird kind of grimy scrap of wood.
Are you then inside it?
But from the way he was acting, it seemed important to him somehow. But to be honest, and what he was asking is such a pain in the ass, I figured he had to be serious about it.
Oh, and since he died right after that.
Yeah, he even said to me, if anything happens to me, take those two talismans. Give them to a guy named Nakagoshi at the police department. Knowing what I know now, he probably felt that something was going to happen to him.
Huh? Nakagoshi?
Huh? Do you know him, Mew?
No, I just heard the name. I think.
So there really is a Nakagoshi. That's a relief, at least. Anyways, it didn't feel right just ignoring a dead guy's last request.
He told me.
Yeah?
That talisman. Would you mind if I had a look at it?
Sorry, but I don't trust you all that much yet. It's important to me.
Okay. So, last night you were looking for the talisman Michio had.
Yeah. And I figured that piece of garbage teacher wouldn't know the most about Michio. I asked him yesterday afternoon if he knew anything about her talisman. Give me some crypto response, like I can't talk about it now. Come to the school tonight. He even gave me the code to the lock on the back entrance. He seemed pretty willing to give it out, so I wouldn't be surprised if he used it for some secret meetings before.
Yep, I can only imagine. We climbed over the front gate to get in.
So yeah, we met up in the classroom in the middle of the night. But nothing he said made any sense. Like that I was really Michio and stuff like that.
Huh?
He went on and on about how it was my fault and that if only I hadn't been around or something. He grabbed a hold of me, breathing heavily.
Were you okay?
Why don't you just fucking lie to me? Yeah, that's right when you two showed up. I was able to get away while Junoichi was freaking out.
Oh my gosh. Good thing you got away.
So really, it's all thanks to you two that I got away. But I didn't get any info about the talisman, so the whole thing was just sort of a bust. Afterwards, I was wondering what you two were up to, so I hid nearby. That's when I saw you and the old man, Ashimiya, talking, and then Mio showed up.
You did?
That's also why I saw Junoichi come back outside and bite it.
I see. So you were only here to look for Michio's talisman.
I was dumb to fall for that creep Junoichi's trap so easily. It could have gone a lot worse, but I lucked out.
What do you describe does sound like Michio killed Mr. Junoichi. She did have a reason to hate him after all.
No way. I mean, that was really, like, her ghost, like, for real.
Those who die bearing strong resentment or regret can occasionally become spirit, either bound to a place or roaming freely. However, it'd usually be impossible for them to kill the living. Most don't have that kind of power. Possible could possess someone close to them to act on those lingering regrets.
Huh. I wonder if that's what happened.
Alright. Then supposing what this braidboard said is true, and Michio's death was an accident. She must have had some regrets. If she really hadn't given up on living, that is. I don't think she was the kind of girl who would just give up, no matter what the situation.
I don't really know, but she didn't seem like she had something tormenting her so much that she'd kill herself. And that's all I know. Happy? Still gotta look for the talisman.
Sure. Thank you, Itomi.
Oh, and if you two find out anything about Michio's talisman...
we'll be sure to let you know.
Thanks.
Oh, can we get your contact info? Where can we normally find you?
Right. I'm not home most of the time. Usually I'm at a friend's place. Here's the phone number.
Thanks. We'll call her if we need to talk with you. And,
what is it?
You're easy to talk to, did I imagine? I was kind of scared at first, but not anymore.
Shut up. You're the one that motherfucking reader that again. Shut up. You're the one avoiding me.
Sun.
Anyways, catch you later. Don't die out there, okay?
Baka.
Thanks. We'll be careful.
Oh, she's just like me for real.
She's great. I love her.
Very good. Very, very good.
Alright.
We got a lot of new information. Sounds like Mr. Junochi was killed by a curse, just as we thought. Which means there was a curse bearer in the school. Multiple, in fact.
Multiple? You think so?
Yes. The curse echo we experienced in the school and the different ones that killed Mr. Junochi seem to be different. The people in the school at the time other than us were... Mr. Junochi, Hitomi, and old man Ashimiya, who you ran into. I was thinking it could be among them, but... there was one more person. Hitomi saw a girl in a school uniform with braids. From what Hitomi was saying, it doesn't seem like she's one. Mr. Junochi is pretty suspicious, though. If he were a curse bearer, it would certainly explain why
he
was killed.
No. If he were a curse bearer, it would certainly explain why he was
killed.
Sorry.
Right. That's why I say there are multiple.
Oh, right. The person who killed Mr. Junochi would have to be one, too. Which means it must be either the mysterious girl or old man Ashimiya?
Yeah. We should be really certainly be careful with them. That said, the mysterious girl and the fact that Mr. Junochi thought it was Michio that was attacking him has me wondering. Of course I doubt Michio herself was actually there, but...
I just remembered. also saw Mr. Araishi outside the main gate last night.
You did? He's involved with the curse, given that he's the one doing research on the Rite of Resurrection.
Still, we'll have to be careful of old Manashimiya and Saraishi. I want to believe that not all curse bearers will be hostile, but...
As for what to do now, I'd like to find who was responsible for the Feast of Shadows that set this off and how they did it. I don't think we'll be able to end this without stopping it at its source.
Nejima.
That makes sense. In which case, next we should do... what exactly?
We'll need to talk with Mr. Araishi. He definitely knows something. It should be safer during the day, so I think we should try to look for him.
Got it. I'll help in any way I can. School is closed. I wonder where he could be.
Let's try heading someplace so someone may know where he is.
Where to go then?
Oh, holy shit.
Exploration.
Ow. So he wouldn't be at the high school.
It's not the high school. Candy shop is her house. So I'm thinking he'd be there. Kamagata Bridge is still pretty close by. I'm gonna take a shot at the former Yasuda Gardens.
Well, stab in the dark.
But
it's 9 a.m.
Just roll with it.
Roll with a stab?
That would be your attack plus your dex mod, and then your proficiency modifier.
My dex is only 6.
You have to have a battle master feat for that. It's pretty harsh.
Mio Kurusuzu and Yanko Sakazaki decided on the next location to investigate.
They sure did.
Oh, okay.
Okay, then.
Maybe we picked the wrong location?
Possibly.
They sure did look somewhere.
That Doendo. You went to the wrong place?
And then they went to a bridge.
Maybe we need to, like, come back when we know, like, where they should probably look for him?
Probably.
I guess maybe someone else would interact with him and he'll tell us.
Yeah, exactly. Detective time again!
Sorting things out.
I'm gonna take care of this gum really quickly.
They're back at Kinshibori.
Sorry for the wait, boss. But I managed to gather some information.
Took you long enough.
Things at the station were pretty hectic, but I managed to get some info. Let me fill you in.
Thanks. Floor's yours.
A total of 3 mysterious deaths were confirmed in the area, including the one in this park. So let's start with that one, the young man we found here.
Oof.
He's been identified as Shogo Okie, 25 years old, a regular old office worker who worked around here. He died of asphyxiation due to water in the lungs. He drowned.
Huh?
Timmy.
Drowned? In the middle of the park? That's not possible. It's gotta be a curse we're dealing with here.
About that, boss. Isn't this park associated with one of the 7 mysteries, too? I think the...
It was the Whispering Canal.
Yeah, Whispering Canal.
Yeah.
That's right! The Whispering Canal!
That's right! Like the Whispering Canal.
That's right!
Doesn't there be like a link between worlds? Link between a canal and death by drowning, don't you think?
I'm thinking Ario. Ario? I always forget what it is.
Ario.
It is Ario? Okay.
Yep.
I'm thinking Ario. Starting to get the hang of this. So let's assume they're related. What's next?
Before that, the body of a woman was found behind a residential complex in Kamezawa. The victim has been identified as Tawako Hayashi, 29 years old. She was an office worker who lived on her own in the area. As for the cause of death, well...
Yes.
The entirety of her body was crushed by some kind of strong external force.
The feet.
No murder weapon was discovered in the area, but considering the way that she was found, we're looking for something large, flat, and heavy that could have crushed her in one fell swoop.
Hang on. You saying it was stepped on?
The foot washing mansion.
Exactly. Crushing is the foot washing mansion's modus operandi. The place the body was discovered is also known to be related to the Seven Mysteries.
This is Namikaki's doing. It. I knew he'd use it. Judging by the amount of soul dregs, the victim was just a regular person, not a curse bearer. Guess we should report this to Paranormal Affairs.
Got it. And as for the third victim, he was identified as Kohei Junoichi, 32, a teacher at Kamigata High. He was found in the school's courtyard. Cause of death appears to be external trauma from a fall or a heavy blow. The impact crushed his arms and legs. Since he was found in the middle of the courtyard, he couldn't have fallen from the gymnasium or the main building.
Teacher dying at school. Not just any school. Kamigata House is one of the Seven Mysteries.
Oh, fuck.
I forget which one this is completely. Was it the...
Check the file.
Was it Haunting Clappers? I don't fucking remember.
You can check the file.
Yeah, check the files.
Uh-huh. Let's see, so... Well, hold on a second. So, let me just go ahead and check... not the Evergreen Beach. Haunting Clappers. The one-sided read? Hold on a second.
No, that was no. Fucking Thumb
That's
Man.
That's Ryogoku Bridge. South Warigasui. The foot... What? No, that's...
That was Weirdo.
Midoricho. Evergreen Beach, near present-day Shumoku Bridge, Hoonji, the Fool's Procession.
Fool's Procession.
Right! For the Fool's Procession is supposed to be. It's too big of a coincidence. We can't rule out the possibility that the death was also the work of a curse. I see. Either way, it seems all three of the victims can be tied to the Seven Mysteries.
Probably a curse bearer at the center of it all, pulling the strings. You've got a point. All these strange deaths do point in one direction.
That's right. And Hajime's case wasn't all that different either. He also died of mysterious causes in a place
He also died of mysterious causes in a place connected to the Seven Mysteries. Problem is, the time doesn't match up. He died before the curses were activated.
Could he have been hit by a different curse? One that didn't have anything to do with the Seven Mysteries?
That's a thought, but... if that were the case, we'd be dealing with a powerful practitioner. One could pull off a curse like that without using a curse stone.
Like in Onmyoji?
There are many people in this day and age who could do something like that.
Oh, really? I see. I don't know much about that stuff.
I'd be more surprised if he did.
Well, looking at these deaths, it seems like many of the curse bearers acted last night.
Can't rule out that there were more killings from which the bodies haven't been found.
Yikes! I hadn't thought of that.
But there is one silver lining. Judging by my own curse stone, it seems that the curses can't be activated while the sun's out.
Oh, that's great news! So basically we're safe during the daytime?
Exactly. It's also likely why Najima gave us until dusk.
Ah, he must have known the curse stones couldn't be used during the day.
Either way, got till nightfall to settle this. It's time we flushed out the other curse bearers.
Aye, aye, boss. Let's do it!
See, so the
Alright, let's continue the scene. Instead of doing what we just said we were gonna do.
At the moment, we only knew the identity of four cursed bearers, you included. Yutaro Namigaki had the foot-washing maiden, mansion, yeah, and Hideki Arashi had the ever-burning lantern. We got both of their curse stones. And then there's Najima, who claims he has the one-sided reed.
Yeah, that about sums it up.
What does the one-sided reed do exactly?
We don't know. I mean, other than kill somebody, we don't know how it works.
Curses people.
Mm-hmm. Check the file.
I mean, we can. The files will almost definitely tell us, but.
Check the file then. Maybe it'll give us something.
We better find out who the remaining five are quick. How should we go about looking for them?
No point in searching blindly without a lead. Let's focus on other things for now. Tracking down Najima might lead us to the other curse bearers, too. Either way, he should be our top priority. He could do some real damage if we don't get him. I also want to look a little more into Yoshimi. I've got a feeling there's some connection there.
Aye aye, boss. Seems like we've got our work cut out for us.
Check the file really quick on the one-sided read. Maybe okay. It really does. There it is. Tomizo fell for a woman named Okoma. Tomizo persistently chased it after Okoma, attempting to win her heart over and over again. She rejected his advances each time. Enraged by her indifference to him, Tomizo brought a dagger to a canal near Ryogoku Bridge and attacked Okoma. He cut the arm and leg off one side of her body, then threw them into the canal. Ever since then, the reeds grow along the canal have only sprouted leaves on one side. Just like Nejima's MO! He cut a body parts and threw them into the canal.
That's true.
I asked around Sumi the community center where Yoshimi was stationed. It seemed like he was investigating the apparent suicide of a girl named Michio Shiraishi.
Yeah. I heard about that.
It's Shiraishi, that's right, yeah. He's trying to determine whether it really was a suicide. Looking into the heights of the building, the force of the impact, her wounds, all that. He must have suspected some kind of foul play, because he ordered a full investigation. But it had already been deemed a suicide, and his superiors told him not to go stirring things up.
What was the evidence?
Well, according to the report I found in his desk last night, the body was found at the foot of a building, a ways away from the road. There's no evidence of vehicular collision, so it was ruled a suicide, but...
But... You thought there was more to it?
Yeah. A truck or other flat-faced vehicle traveling at high speeds could have inflicted similar damage. In other words, sometimes a traffic accident can look like an awful lot like a fall.
But there's a chance it wasn't a suicide. What a terrible way to go.
There was no brake marks on the road, meaning it would have been a hit and run. The vehicle would have hit her without slowing down at all.
This is turning into quite the grisly case. The vehicle couldn't have come out of a collision like that unscathed.
Exactly. So I asked the traffic bureau to keep an eye out for any vehicles with frontal damage. But I haven't heard back from them yet. I don't think they're looking very hard.
So we've got no proof. That said, it was a traffic accident rather than a suicide. It's possible that someone silenced Yoshimi because he was on the verge of discovering the truth.
That's true. You think the driver is the one who did him in?
Not quite. Yoshimi had already talked to forensics and the traffic bureau, right? His death wouldn't have covered things up.
You're right on that. Even if the suicide was a cover-up for a hit and run, it doesn't seem like enough of a reason to kill a cop. Oh, that's right! Unrelated, but I got something else, too. I managed to get a hold of Michiro Shiraishi's address. Yoshimi went through a bunch of... went through a bunch over the course of his investigation. Might be a good idea for us to drop by, too.
Thinking. Hopefully that'll give us some more leads. Alright. Let's move on to the next topic.
Remember the girl Yoshimi met with the day he died? One Hitomi Yokuda? Community safety didn't have any contact information for her on hand.
Not even her address.
Well, they had her parents' information, but when I called, they said that he hadn't heard from her in months. Lots of family issues, from the sound of it. They even said that they didn't want anything to do with her anymore.
Ooh.
That said, she still goes to school once in a while, so we might be able to find her there.
Not sure we really have the time for a stakeout right now. She could be a key witness. Can we have community safety track her down for us?
Yeah, we can ask. But it might be tricky to get done today. For starters, Kamigata High School is closed today.
Ah. Because of the teacher that died?
That's right.
Alright. But if it's not something we can do today, we may have to forget about it. Let's move on, then.
Forget about it.
I got some information about Yoshimi's fiancé from Community Safety. Her name is Maya Chozawa. Yeah. 27 years old. She works at a beautician in the area. Look, I have managed to get a picture of her. She sure is a beauty. But...
oh boy, here it comes. But what?
Community Safety hasn't been able to contact her since Yoshimi died. Not by phone or at her house. In other words, no response. Dead silence.
Hmm.
There it is. Can't things just be easy for once?
Oh. Yeah, okay, she's gonna be important.
Oh! Ooh, love her hair.
I also want this.
Yes, queen.
I mean, yeah, congrats. You just, yeah, you get it. Because, like, she's on the fucking... she's just, like, deadass, like, one of the characters on the fucking, like, big, like, splash wall art thing.
The one we forgot about.
Yeah.
Yoshimi's fiancé.
Love her hair.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely starting to look suspect. Crime of passion, perhaps.
It is fairly common for people to be killed by a lover or a spouse. But Yoshimi was well-liked, and they've been together for over 10 years.
You never know. Things could be different behind closed doors.
Speaking from experience?
I guess so.
Han killed her first lover.
Oh my god.
Wait, what?
But we'll have to consider the opposite scenario, too. Could be that the same person searched for Yoshimi after his fiancé as well. Could be in danger.
Hmm.
You're right. Either way, she's important to the case. She already has people looking for her. We'll know as soon as she's found.
That is always a problem.
HQ has mobilized a search unit for Nejima. But so far we haven't received any word.
Destiny wasn't at home or at work.
About that. Apparently he vacated his last known address a week ago.
Are you serious? We have no idea where he lives.
It gets worse. I checked in with the factory he was working at. They told me he was only there for a month before he quit.
Hold on a second. You're telling me nobody caught that?
Well, I had the same thought, so I spoke to his probation officer. Turns out he's been doing house visits and interviews. I never bothered checking on his workplace.
Oh, come on!
He also said he lost track of Nejima when he moved to a new place.
Jeez. It's just sloppy.
How the fuck do you lose your prisoner?
Oh my god!
I wonder they're giving direct parole to just about anyone these days because they're running out of room in the prisons. Which also means there aren't enough probation officers to go around. Dude's probably overworked.
So Nejima gotta fuck around unsupervised. God damn it. That asshole's annoyingly good at faking remorse or insanity, whatever the situation calls for. Back when I arrested him all those years ago, just talking to him left a bad taste in my mouth.
He's probably hiding under a false name, which will make it harder to track him down. That'd explain why he so brazenly made contact.
That asshole. He's mocking us.
Well, for now, the paperwork to circulate his name and mugshot is being filed.
It's gonna take way too long. We only have until dusk.
Speaking of Nejima.
Yeah?
Did you manage to reach your daughter? You asked to put her into protective custody as soon as possible.
Not yet. Can't reach her. Oh, but she's not picking up. Wasn't home when they went to the house either.
That's not good! Does that mean she never came home? And why were you the only one trying to reach her?
Shut up. Never contacting for all right.
Damn, she really doesn't trust you, huh?
Either way, I told her mother that it was an emergency, and we'd send an officer to find her and get her to safety. He was real reluctant. But I got her to agree.
I guess that explains why you got divorced, huh? But if you, her former father, can't find her, how the hell did Nejima do it?
Former, eh? That cuts deep.
Yikes, sorry. It kinda just slipped out.
Anyway, I suspect it has something to do with this curse echo.
Back on topic already, huh?
Said a curse echo could kill a lot of people in a short time. May even allow them to act from distance.
I see.
A one-sided read. What was that story about again?
Something about me stalking a woman who wasn't seen and chops her up.
Alright. One of the more gruesome of the seven mysteries.
As for Nejima's whereabouts, all we can do is throw more people at it until we find something. I'll check in with HQ frequently to see if they got any updates. And that's about it. Shall we continue our investigation? We can go to Komagata High School to look into Hitomi Okuda, or to Michio Shiraishi's house to find out more about her. Oh, let's get moving. Well, I mean, we'll get moving and then we'll pick it up next time. Oh yeah, that's it! Oh shit!
Oh man!
Esso's back again.
Guess we'll catch up on MILF Hours next time.
Mm-hmm. Cool beans. The story is progressing. Very, very
and we're
nice.
Charting.
The mystery continues.
Very, very good. Very nice.
Yeah, the shadow remains cast.
You know, come to think of it, wow, like, these were very strategically positioned, because it's like, these ones can't branch, but this one can, because it has space underneath it.
Don't worry about it.
Damn, this dude just got fucked. Goddamn, ripping piss, Shogo Okie. Alrighty then, that'll be the end of today's session. We will see you all again on Monday. Good night.
Bye-bye.
Good night.
Bye-bye. I'll leave it there.
Dang it, this is too good.
Yeah.